Hello friends, welcome to ChemShastra. As I have committed that very soon I will be coming with new ways to remember your P block elements. Now this is a video where we are going to discuss how we can remember P block elements very efficiently. Now before beginning with all the P block elements, this is just a classification of your complete periodic table. Now the basic introduction regarding your periodic table we have already done in our first part of remembering S block elements. So let's try to understand today what we are going to discuss. Now out of this periodic table, now main concern for today's video will be we'll be discussing boron family, carbon family, nitrogen family, oxygen family, halogen family, as well as your inert gas elements. So let's begin. Now first group what we are going to discuss today is group 13 element, which is also referred to as the boron family, which is having 5 elements. One is a boron, then aluminium, next is a gallium, indium and thallium with their respective atomic numbers. Now again the same stuff, I am not expecting you to remember the atomic numbers. I will tell you how you can arrive at atomic numbers, okay, when I will discuss the inert gas elements. Let's try to understand what is their symbolic representation. Boron is represented as capital B, aluminium is Al, gallium is represented as Ga, indium is represented as Ir, and thallium is represented as Tl. Now what sentence you can remember to make sure that you will know all these 5 elements in a one particular group, and that sentence is Barbara and Alfred gathered in the Taylor's living room. Now don't worry about who is Barbara, who is Alfred, who is Taylor's. Okay, just focus on the sentence. It will be very easy for you to remember all these 5 elements with the help of this sentence. That sentence goes like this: Barbara and Alfred gathered in the Taylor's living room. Now from Barbara, your capital B stands for the boron, Alfred ka Al is for aluminium, gathered ka Ga is for gallium, in ka Ir is for indium, and from Taylor's you can select your T as well as L, which will stands for your thallium. Now if you look into the valence electron configuration, it goes something like this: 2s to 2p1, 3s to 3p1, 4s to 4p1, 5s to 5p1 and 6s to 6p1. So don't now this is what I have written, 2s electron config, just to show that second is a valence shell for boron, third is a valence shell for the aluminium, fourth is a valence shell for gallium, fifth is a valence shell for indium, and 6 is the valence shell for your thallium element. Now let's try to understand why they are put into P block element. A very simple stuff: the last electron enters into the P subshell. So if we'll see in the case of boron, last electron is entering into the P subshell. If you do know the above principle, it goes like first your 1s get filled, then 2s and then 2p. So your last electron in boron is entering into P subshell, that's why it's a P block element. Similarly goes for your aluminium, gallium, indium and thallium. Okay, so this was all about a group 13 elements. Now let's move on to the next group, that is a group 14 element, which you can call it as a carbon family. Now in this family again you are having 5 elements. First is a carbon, second one is silicon, third one is germanium, fourth one is tin, and last one is lead with their atomic numbers 6, 14, 32, 50 and 82. Don't remember this atomic number for now. I can expect you to remember this atomic number because carbon is very important element in your chemistry, because it forms complete organic chemistry as a separate branch where you are having billions of compounds synthesized by now. So let's try to understand the symbolic representation. Carbon is represented as capital B, silicon is Si, germanium is Ge, then you are having tin which is Sn, and lead will be represented as Pb. Now these are the Latin origin of tin and lead. So Sn stands for your, if you think of your Sn element, which is tin, you can understand that this is originated from your Latin stuff. Your Sn stands for stannum and your Pb stands for plumbum. Okay, so it's very difficult words, but you can remember them. But you can remember that Sn is called tin and very well known as tin, Pb is very well known as lead. Now how to remember this all the elements? A very simple sentence: capital is from Silicon Valley and Germany send their employees to pub. Now this may be a dream to people who are working in corporate offices, because no employer will send their employees to pub for no reason. Okay, so just, we are just assuming that this is the ideal situation for the working people, so don't worry much about that, but this is just a fun part of what I added over here. So it will be like capital is capital C stands for carbon, Silicon Valley ka SI is for silicon, then your germanium ka GE is for germanium. From send you can pick up S and N, that will be for tin, Sn. Okay, and then from pub you can pick up P and B, which stand for your lead. Now let's try to understand their valence electron configuration. It goes like 2s2 2p2, then 3s2 3p2 for silicon, 4s2 4p2 for germanium, 5s2 5p2 for tin, and 6s2 6p2 for lead. Again the same stuff, carbon is having second shell as their valence shell, silicon is having third shell as their valence shell, germanium is having fourth shell as their valence shell, tin is having fifth shell as their valence shell, and for lead 6 is the valence shell. Again, if you remember your above principle ka sequence, it goes like 1s, 2s and then 2p. So the last electron from carbon is entering into p subshell, that's why it is a p block element. For the silicon the same case, for germanium the same case, for tin the same case, and for lead the same case. Now it's very important that you can study all the elements according to their group. It becomes very easy for you to understand their chemistry, because if we'll see this electron configuration of all this group elements, having electron configuration as s2, then you are having p2. Now only point of difference is their valence shell, so that is only what the thing is going to change. Otherwise their valence shell, number of electrons in valence shell is going to remain the same, and because of that their physical and chemical properties are similar. Okay, let's move on to the next group, that is group 15 element, which is your nitrogen family. Now nitrogen family is also having 5 elements in their group. First one is nitrogen, then you are having phosphorus, arsenic, antimony and bismuth, having their respective atomic numbers of 7, 15, 33, 51 and 83. Now what is their symbolic representation? Nitrogen is represented as capital N, phosphorus is represented as capital P, arsenic as As, and antimony is represented as Sb. Now this Sb is again originated from Latin term which is called stibium, okay, but it is very well known as antimony. Okay, then your next one is your bismuth, right? Now if you will understand what is the mnemonic thing what I have made for this is, no one puts Asian sailboat in the rivers of Bihar, where your no one ka N stands for nitrogen, puts ka P stands for phosphorus, from Asian your AS stands for arsenic, sailboat ka S and B if you will pick up, it stands for SB, that is your stibium or antimony, and from Bihar you can pick up BI for bismuth. If you look into their valence electron configuration, it goes like 2s2 2p3, 3s2 3p3 for phosphorus, 4s2 4p3 for arsenic, and 5s2 5p3 for your antimony, and last one is 6s2 6p3 for bismuth. Same thing for nitrogen, second is the valence shell, for phosphorus third is the valence shell, for arsenic fourth is the valence shell, for antimony fifth is the valence shell, and for bismuth 6 is the valence shell. I hope you know what is a valence shell. It is a last shell. Now again the same understanding you can have over here. The last electron is entering into the p subshell for nitrogen. For phosphorus the last electron is again entering into p subshell. For arsenic last electron or the valence electron is entering into p subshell. For antimony it is also entering into p subshell, and for bismuth as well it is entering into p subshell. That's why they are classified under p block elements. If we'll talk about there how many valence electron they have, 2 plus 3, that is going to be equal to 5. So if we'll see all this elements of nitrogen family, they are going to have same number of valence electrons. So again, because of this, they will have similar physical as well as chemical properties, and that's the only reason they have put into a same group. Okay, so we'll move ahead with the next group, that is group 16 element, which is your oxygen family. Now if we'll talk about oxygen, in oxygen you have 5 elements. One is oxygen, first element is oxygen, second is sulfur, third one is selenium, then you have tellurium, and last one is polonium, with their atomic number as 8, 12, 34, 52 and 84. What is the symbolic representation? Oxygen is capital O, sulfur is capital S, selenium is SE, tellurium is TE, and polonium is PO. What is the mnemonic sentence what you can use to remember this is, oh, Sam is selling their Porsche. Now don't worry, maybe you must be thinking ki Porsche bhi itna bada bada brand use kar raha hai. It's okay. Okay, if you can remember this sentence, it will be very beneficial for you to remember the all elements. So O ka O is for oxygen, Sam ka S is for sulfur. From selling, you can take SE for selenium. From there, you can pick up T and E is for tellurium. And for Porsche, you can use PO for polonium. Now what is the valence electron configuration? For oxygen, it is 2s2 2p4. For sulfur, it is 3s2 3p4. For selenium, it is going to be 4s2 4p4. For tellurium, it is going to be 5s2 5p4. And for polonium, it is going to be 6s2 6p4. Again, the same logic. For oxygen, second is the valence shell. For sulfur, third is the valence shell. For selenium, fourth is the valence shell. For tellurium, your fifth is the valence shell. And for polonium, your sixth is the valence shell. Now, if you talk about why these are under p-block elements, again, the same logic goes. if you see the over here, P4, P is having a maximum capacity of accommodating 6 electron. So last electron of oxygen entering into P subshell, that's why it's a P block element. Same goes for sulfur, your selenium, tellurium, as well as the polonium. Now if you talk about how many valence electron they do have, the last electron you can count from in S you are having 2 electron and in P you are having 4 electrons. So 4 plus 2 comes out to be 6 electrons. So for oxygen, valence electron are going to be 6. For sulfur, the same number it's going to be there, 6. For selenium, valence electron are going to be 6. For tellurium, 6. As well as for polonium, 6. That's the only reason they belong to same group and they are going to have similar physical as well as chemical properties. Okay. Let's move on to the second last group of your P block element, that is your group 17, which is your halogen family. Now this is something which you must be very well aware of. Okay, one element which we don't talk much about is a fluorine, being more corrosive element. So this family is having 5 elements. One is fluorine, second element is a chlorine, third is bromine, fourth is iodine, and the last element is astatine with their respective atomic number of 9, 17, 35, 53 and 85. If you talk about the symbolic representation, fluorine is represented as capital F, chlorine is represented as Cl, bromine is represented as Br, iodine as capital I, and acetine is as At. Now what is the mnemonic sentence what you can remember is, four clever brothers came in same attire. Now from four, your capital F represents fluorine, clever ka Cl is for chlorine, brother ka Br is for bromine. From in, you can pick only I, that stands for iodine. And attire ka AT stands for acetine. Let's try to understand their valence electron configuration. For fluorine, it is going to be 2s2 2p5. Second is the valence shell. For chlorine, it is going to be 3s2 3p5. Third is the valence shell. For bromine, 4s2 4p5. Fourth is the valence shell. For iodine, it is going to be 5s2 5p5. Fifth is the valence shell. And for acetine, 6s2 6p5. Sixth is going to be the valence shell. If you talk about how many electrons they do have in the last shell, 2 plus 5, that comes out to be 7 electrons. For chlorine, again, number of valence electrons are 7. For bromine, number of valence electrons are going to be 7. You can count this 2 plus 5. For iodine, again, it is going to be 7. And for astatine, it is going to be 7. This is the only reason why your halogens are very electronegative elements of your periodic table. They are considered to be the highly electronegative element of your periodic table. If you do remember your lower standard, you know octet rule. If you are having 8 electrons in your valence shell, that atom becomes very stable, or they show behavior as that of your noble gas elements. So you can see over here, only all these halogens requires only one single electron to achieve that electron configuration. That's the only reason they are very electronegative elements. And you can consider this fluorine is a highly electronegative element of your periodic table. So you can consider fluorine is highest electronegative element of your periodic table. Okay, so now let's move on to the last group of your P block element, that is your noble gas elements, which is having 6 element in it, which is first one starting with helium, then you are having neon, argon, krypton, xenon and radon with their atomic number of 2, 10, 18, 36, 54 and 86. Now what is the symbolic representation? Helium is represented as He, neon is Ne, argon is Ar, krypton is Kr, xenon is Xc and radon is Rn. Now what is the mnemonic sentence you can make to remember this? First one is, you can remember it as, he never argues with Christopher, Zen and Rian. Now who is Christopher, who is Zen and who is Rian? Don't worry about who they are. Just focus on this sentence to remember your noble gas element sequence. And that is, he never argues with Christopher, Zen and Rian. Where he ka H is for helium, neon ka N is for neon, argues ka Ar is for argon, Christopher ka Kr is for krypton, Zen ka X is for xenon, and from Rian you can take R and N, which stands for your radon element. Now what is their electron configuration? For helium it is a 1s2. Now don't be shocked why this is put into P block element. Now this is something which is exception in your periodic table, that helium is put into noble gas element because it is showing same physical as well as chemical properties as that of your new noble gas element, but you can also put it into S block element. Okay, so this is something like occasionally we put helium into P block element, but you can consider it is a group wise classification as well. So all the elements are having the same physical or similar physical and chemical properties, belongs to one particular group. So ideally your helium should belong to S block element, but if you see group wise classification, it is put under group 18, which is your inert gas element. So don't worry about that. It is a highly stable element. Then if you talk about neon, it is 2s2 2p2, so valence shell is second. For argon, the valence shell is third. For krypton, it is going to be the fourth is going to be the valence shell. For xenon, it is going to be fifth. Fifth is going to be the valence shell. And for radon, six is going to be the valence shell. Now, how many electrons they do have in their valence shell? 2 plus 6 is going to be 8 electrons. For neon, for helium, it is going to be 2 electrons. Okay. Then for argon, number of valence electrons are going to be 8. For krypton, it is going to be 8. For xenon, it is going to be 8 again. And for radon, it is going to be 8 again. Now, what the octet rule says? If you are having 8 electrons in the valence shell, they are very stable. So, all these noble gas elements are highly stable because they are having 8 electrons in their valence shell. Now, this is the one thing which makes them behave as a noble gas element or inert gas elements. Why? Because they don't need to accept electron or give away electron to achieve extra stability. They are already very stable. And that's the only reason why your noble gas elements are present as monoatomic gases. Now, what do you mean by monoatomic gases? That means only one single atom forms a molecule. Okay. So, like helium will be present as a helium gas, He gas. No He2, He4, kuch bhi nahi. Okay. Similarly for all the other elements. Okay friends, so here we complete our explanation or mnemonic technique on how to remember p-block elements. Now if you want to make your life and chemistry easy, do join our channel on YouTube, that is ChemShastra. Be the winner in all walks of life, that is what our tagline is. Like this video, do share this video with your friends who want to understand, who want to remember p-block element very thoroughly, and do subscribe to our channel for more such content.